Hello, in this video we'll talk about string functions. So let's start with formatting of strings. So here I have a piece of code where I am printing a list of numbers. Since I want to print individual numbers, what I do is I take a string, say dot format, and pass all the three integers. So nums0, nums1, nums2 indicate the 0th, first and second element from the list. And these are printed because by the convention, these curly brackets, you know, corresponds to each of these numbers. So we have three blocks of code here. And so this is printed nums0, nums1, nums2. So format works with, you have to pass X number of parameters here and X number of brackets should be present here. And each is corresponded directly. So the first one corresponds to the first one in the parameter. The second block will correspond to the second one in the parameter. The third block here will correspond to the third one in the parameter. Similarly, one can use a named argument. So named arguments, the advantage is that you put the names here like A, B, C, these are the names. And then inside format, you can have any order of these arguments. So for example, A, B, C, whereas here the order is B, A, C. And because this matching happens via the names, you know, the output still remains the same. Let's see some Python string functions. Python is very, very intuitive and there are a lot of normal standard library functions. For example, here we want to append a list of string elements. So you have a list where there are three words, life is good, and we want to join them with a comma. So all we need to do is, you know, say comma dot join and pass that list. So it joins all the words in the list with comma. So this is what you get, life is good. Now if you want to replace good with strange, right, you just call a replace function. Please note how intuitive the function names are there, right? Similarly, you want to replace hello, you know, with namaste. So you are replacing all the hellos. So this is going to make this new string with namaste world, namaste Python. Similarly, you want to check whether a string starts with hello. So you just say starts with, right? You want to check whether a string ends with certain strings. For example, here ends with Python. It gives you, a function ends with. You have more functions like upper, you know, take a string, make it upper, take a string, make it lower. You have a string, a comma separated string, and you want to split it. All you do is take that string and dot split comma. So for example, a lion, tiger, elephant, dot split comma, and you get a list of lion, tiger and elephant. So the key point is that there are a lot of many intuitive functions which makes the life of a programmer very easy. There are many more. I would encourage you to go and see the documentation. So this is in short all the string functions. Next video, we'll see numeric functions. Thank you.